I'm so happy you're here.
Thank you so much for having me. This is very exciting for me.
Great.
I have something for you, just
as a
thank you for having me gift.
Okay.
You can open it. Or you can save it for later. Or, open it.
Okay, you sure?
Yeah, that's nice to do, right?
Yeah.
When the person's there.
It's $40.
Yeah. I mean, this is really helps promote the show, so I just wanted to give you something to show that, like, you know, how thankful I am for you having me.
Well, thank you. That's
very
thoughtful.
You're welcome.
That's very thoughtful.
You can spend it on anything you want.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
For the uninitiated, explain the premise of the show, Nathan For You.
Nathan For You, I go to real small businesses, and I give them out-of-the-box or innovative ways they can better market themselves or improve their business.
So, for example, you go to a women's boutique this year.
Yes.
Now, what is the business plan you present?
So, next week's episode, I go to a women's boutique, and there's a lot of couples in this neighborhood, so you know how, you know, women will come with their boyfriends or husbands.
Sure.
But they'll feel a psychological pressure to leave because the husband's just sitting there.
And they hate being there.
Yeah. So I create a man zone in the back of the women's clothing store.
Uh-huh.
So the men have a place to, you know, chill.
Okay.
While the women shop.
All right. I think we have a clip, so let's take a look
at
this.
Great. Just so you guys know, Elizabeth Albert has a dedicated man zone. So that means while the lady shops, you have a place you can hang out that's both comfortable and geared towards your masculine needs. So if you want to come hang out there and give her time to shop, if you want, it's up to you.
Yeah.
Okay. Don't leave this bro hanging, dog. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Great. And we'll be having fun in there, so take as much time as you need.
All right, thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
I knew it wouldn't be too much of a challenge to lure guys into the zone. And once they saw it had everything a guy could want, I was hopeful they wouldn't want to leave.
Free at last, huh?
And it worked pretty well?
Yeah, I mean, it was a challenge, you know, I had to try to keep the guys comfortable in there, and we had royalty-free football on the screens.
So by royalty-free football, I mean you can't show NFL.
We can't show NFL because it's a show, so it was, you know, clips from the Houston Gamblers.
Okay, like old USFL teams and stuff?
Arizona Gunslingers.
Okay.
Yeah, which... you know, whatever was available on Getty.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, we met for the first time at the Emmys 2 years ago. I was hosting the Emmys.
Yeah.
We were at an Emmy party together, and I came over because I'm such a huge fan of the show to say hello.
Yeah, you were really nice. You came up to me, and I felt really embarrassed after because I forgot you were hosting the Emmys.
Yeah, that's
that
fine.
Year.
That's okay.
And you were talking to me, but the whole time, you were giving me kind of these weird looks like, you were like, you know, like you wanted me to say, oh, congratulations. And I didn't know at the time, like you wanted a compliment. No, I understand. Because it's a big thing to host
that.
The Emmys. That's exciting.
Yeah, well, but I wasn't.
But you wanted a compliment from me and I didn't give it to you. And afterwards I felt bad because I'm like, oh, that's why he kept pausing and kind of going like this during the conversation.
I never did that.
You did, it's okay, but I feel bad about it and I just want to say sorry.
Okay.
And. Congratulations on
that.
That's really exciting.
That's too late.
Well, I mean, Seth,
I still don't think I did that.
You don't think you...
I don't think I did this.
It's okay, Seth. It's part of your personality. I mean, you're a different way on the show than you are at these private parties, but...
That's true.
This
is... So you
have an image. You know,
this isn't the real thing.